So what did the doctor say? Okay. Well, that's tough, but not the end of the world. Come on, let's go get some ice cream and we can talk.
HIV stands for human immunodeficiency virus. It's a virus that attacks the body's immune system. HIV can be transmitted when someone has unprotected sex with a person who has HIV, from sharing needles for tattooing or injecting drugs with a person who has HIV, or from breast milk if the mother has HIV. People can also be born with HIV if the person who gives birth to them is living with the HIV. When someone learns that they have HIV, they may experience a whole host of feelings. Some may feel confused, vulnerable, or scared. Others may feel sad or upset. Some may see the situation as unfair, which could lead to feelings of anger or depression. Everyone's reaction is different, but all are completely normal and part of the process of accepting life with a chronic or long-term illness. Doctors don't have a way to cure HIV yet, but they are working on it. And if a person takes care of themselves, they can live a long and healthy life with it. Medicine used to treat HIV is called antiretroviral therapy, or ART. Seeing the doctor regularly and taking the medicines as prescribed, exercising regularly, reducing stress, getting enough sleep, and eating healthy foods can help someone living with HIV to live a long and healthy life. People living with HIV can do the same types of exercise as people who do not have HIV. Playing on a sports team is a great way to stay fit, to reduce stress, and to be social. There are state and federal laws that protect the rights of people living with HIV, including the right to participate in school activities and sports. People living with HIV can also be in relationships and have sex by taking a few precautions, like making sure their medications are keeping their HIV in check, using condoms if they do have vaginal or anal sex, and if their partner does not have HIV, helping them to get a medication called PrEP that can prevent HIV transmission from one person to another. Sometimes a person living with HIV may feel isolated or alone, like they're the only one in school who has this experience. Deciding to tell friends or classmates can help someone living with HIV to feel less alone, but it is a very individual decision whether or not to tell people and should be theirs alone to make. It's okay if they decide not to tell people about their HIV status. If you have questions about HIV, it's helpful to identify a trusted adult you can talk to about this kind of stuff and can help you make informed decisions.
Till next time, don't forget to visit me at amaze.org or go to my YouTube channel to watch more. Bye!